Thank you so much. Hi, my name is Marcus. I'm passionate about design and technology. As well, introduced by he made me sound pretty good. But one thing I want to talk about is that since my love for technology and design has helped create this amazing platform that has helped various communities around the world sell their new stuff and help people who can't afford access and stuff. But the key thing here that I want to talk today is not about Carousell, it's not about it, it's about passion. Pursuing that passion that I had in design and technology, and pursuing passion is really tough, especially in Asia, especially in Singapore. You have dreams, but you also have your parents' dreams, you also have society's expectation of what stated code is. And we always struggle. I have parents who ask me, like, hey, when are you going to find a job? A real job. Not like doing some apps that you don't make money in the long term. And we haven't until recently, but that's like 3 years in, we finally started monetizing. And it's a long, tough journey in terms of like delivering the expectations to your parents and to society. I have a lot of friends asking me, when are you going to get married? When we get married, we're going to find a girlfriend. These are the kind of things that you struggle pursuing your passion. And that's something that I want to touch a little bit on today. So what is data scope? Let's get a quick Google. Brought to this vocabulary.com page. And if you look at like what it means is that if you are rich and admired, you're not probably interested in shopping. So people who are not rich and good and well off, they have that hunger. They have that hunger, they have that thirst, they want to disrupt the years ago. And that is what I noticed with my co-founders, Siri and Lucas, my two partners at Carousell. We are not well off. We are people that fell in love with tech, fell in love with design, fell in love with software engineering, and we built up Carousell. We went through 2 years without any salary. Everyone talks about the struggling times, everyone talks about, yes, you have funding, you have users, you have venture capitalists backing you, you start monetizing. Everyone talks about that, but no one talks about the tough times, the first 2 years. And this is Singapore. This is a very nice place, and there's a reason why it's a very nice place. You have schools training you to score well on exams. You have tuitions. The tuition industry is close to 1 billion. That was 2015. I'm sure it's a lot of people right now. People are just like force feeding you to study really hard, go to university, go to the top university of your choice. And that's the second choice. The first choice is go to the top university in the US. I usually get a scholarship in government service, come back and become a minister if you can, if not be a public service servant. And that's exactly the culture in Singapore. And I think most of Asia as well. Your parents, they tell you, you're going to study hard, you're going to do this, you're going to do that. And after that, you find a girlfriend. and there's so much articles out there that tell you how to spot your girlfriend. And after you buy a house, you need to buy a car. Cars in Singapore are super expensive, and likewise, property in Singapore is super expensive, so we live in really small apartments. And then your kids, they ask you during Chinese New Year, during New Year, they ask you when you have kids. When are you going to have girlfriend first? Things like this, these are kind of like the status quo of how life should be, how the world works. That's how like people's expectation of you. But the truth is, life is not about checklist of things that maybe have meaning to you. For all that I've shared, if that's something that you're happy with, perfectly fine as well. But for people who are passionate about something, like for myself, I was passionate about design all this while. It started actually with the Sony Walkman. I just love how like a simple product so elegantly designed can actually produce music. I'm not a music maker. I can't sing to save my life. But I really love like holding the Sony Walkman, you know, the iPod. Steve Jobs made the iPod looks amazing. Like this piece of simple like device, but so much technology behind it, and simplifying it, making it so simple for the world. And that's my passion. I want to do something like that. But I chose the parents' path, asking you to go to university, study business, try to get into a bank, try to get a consulting if you can. All these things are just like noise there. But deep down in the heart, there's this calling that I want to do something with design, really creative. So what if you can challenge this status quo? What if you can actually have ideas of how to challenge it? And that's exactly when I reflect what really helped me was having these three things. And things that you can actually build up, which is having the courage. We always use the word passion. We overuse the word passion sometimes, but understanding what passion really means and asking people, surrounding yourself with the right people. So firstly, what is courage? I found courage when we were like, what exactly is courage when I spent a year in the US, so part of the university program, they send students to Silicon Valley. So we work in tech startups, work in the class at Stanford. And I worked with my, the startup I worked at was a very small fintech company, less than 10 people. The founders were Harvard, he stayed in Manhattan, very wealthy family background, but he totally took a leap of faith and jumped into the startup world. He could have a very nice job at a pharmaceutical company that makes tons of money. But when I learned about how he actually totally left New York to join, come to Silicon Valley and show everything to us, I truly understand like how people like have to make sacrifice and you have to have the courage to say no. And that was one of the key things that I draw back from my Silicon Valley. So this is the north of Silicon Valley, San Francisco, where you have all the likes of like Airbnb, the recent like, startups at Airbnb, Dropbox, all from there. You go further south, you have Facebook, Google, and then Apple. So when we came back, we were like thinking, okay, what kind of problems can we like solve? Right? I mean, it's such a simple pitch that I can stretch. And there was no like calamine lotion, there's no like ointment to solve it. That was my example. So I'm a fanatic photographer. I used to go through forums to find the most vintage cameras that I buy. And after I sell it at a higher price actually sometimes. And I find that the poor buying experience was just very painful. To sell something, you photo, you copy it, you upload it, it takes a lot of time. And it wasn't the best experience of the world for me. So that was the whole idea. It was a whole mini project, a hackathon competition that we joined called Startup Weekend, where me and my other co-founders started building the first version of Carousell, which was just a mini project. And we nearly didn't make it. We were 20, I think, 4 or maybe 15. We only chose 20 teams for the final round. But thankfully, the 4 teams in the 20th, in the 20 list, dropped out. They gave up. So they had a few people into the final round. So they chose our team. And thankfully, we won. But the biggest thing was a meeting. They were like tweeting, sharing on Facebook, and leaving an email that they wanted to try an app like Carousell. And those were our friends, those were people that we never met before. So that gave us a leap of faith. And back then I rejoined a company called Oracle's IT company. I was doing well, doing business development, and I just quit. I just left that and joined Syria and was my co-founders to start Carousell. And that was our first office, mini office that we moved into. It's a very scrappy setup, shared with 3 other startups, and just being mainly like stealing space anywhere to find just the first version of Carousell. And that was how, that was early days. So that, being able to take the courage, to take the faith was something that you have to be thick-skinned about. And the most difficult one is that you tell your parents that. I had to tell my parents I want to try this, I want to quit my job, and they immediately got to me for a few weeks. They're like, what? Like I supported you to school and you're like, I want to do this, and then we try to explain to them what is the app, you know, what's the app. And you ask them like, oh, it's like take a photo of the camera and they're like, how do you make money? It's like, I don't know yet. Yeah, so these are things that you have like the courage to just be positive, staying focused, and really just solving user problems, like community problems. So it's just something that the last, even to today, 5 years in, we still use the core value right now of being very focused on like, solving user problems. And thankfully, this is a recent photo, they are smart. I couldn't take a photo and just holding me because it's not right. And this is a digital cafe. I just want to share this bit of like how life was back then. You see Instagram, what we're sharing, the travel photos, hashtag wanderlust, hashtag digital cafe. And on the weekend, you are actually in the office working hard, figuring out a lot of things, right? Actually, I'm a business school, so I know nothing about design, so I learn how to figure out this workshop, now I sketch, learning how to like, draw wireframes, understanding typography, reading out all of these things. And these things are like a trade-off. And this is a real food that you're eating every day. It's economical rice. It's not lean, it's very fattening, but it's a lean lifestyle. Where you just it costs like $3 or $4. So yeah, having the courage to say no, to really look at other people's lifestyle and say I'm sorry, this is passion. You chose passion over all these things, right? You gotta live with it. The second one is very important is people, surrounding yourself with people that resonates with you and that similar values with you. And I was very fortunate to have really two I can't think of better co-founders in this journey. Siri and Lucas. I know Siri for close to 13 years, close to sorry, less than that, but close to that. And then Lucas for 5 years now in the journey. And they reflect the kind of values that I have, we are passionate about technology, we are super resourceful, we don't take no, we figure things out, there's nothing that can't be done. And that's how we got to where we are today. Figuring out how do we scale the team, how do we launch more markets, how do we raise capital, how do we hire the executive team. And that was the early days. And we have scaled throughout time, the last 5 years, from 3 of us to 7, to 30, to 50, 60, to now 144. And we managed to figure out how to hire a diverse team. We have close to 16 nationalities, from Kazakhstan to India, to America, to Ukraine, to Russia. And we also hired out the team that actually can mentor the junior people who join us. And we built our executive team over time. People from Airbnb joining us, people from Property Guru, Alibaba, people who are IPO companies. And we spent the last 1 year learning how to figure out how to bring people, how to inspire people on the executive level to join us, to really partner us in this journey. These are our executive right now. And we basically surround ourselves with people better than me. So following your passion is tough. You need the best people around you to actually keep you sane, to keep you motivated, to keep you in check. And these are our two great co-founders of that, and now we have a team in the executive team that is to help the rest of the transition scale in that sense as well. Lastly, passion. A lot of people use this word. We use the word a lot. What exactly is passion? So I know you guys watched the movie. You guys haven't watched it. You guys should check it out. It's an amazing movie. And people love what I'm going to talk about is passion. And what exactly is passion? Passion is greed. It's really greed and, lack of a better word, when the going gets tough, you are excited about it. And when I talk about excited, you really go down and do things that go to your effect. And these are kind of things that you do on the weekends where passion just drives or goes on overdrive. We go to every flea market, we give flyers. People ask us how we launch our next car. This is how we launch it. I read up quite a few literature on this. Airbnb founders went to every single apartment to take photos of the house. Pinterest founders went to every Apple store and bookmarked Pinterest on the Safari. They have Mark Zuckerberg figuring out how to email at scale, communicate the Facebook value proposition. So doing things at that scale something that is key, and to do that, you need passion. And this is us giving water bottles, exchange for dollars, people shunning us, or even like avoiding us, and we take a nap. After a long day, we take a nap, and we go again, and we keep going again, and never stop. And when people ask us like, when was the inflection point for Carousell, there wasn't any. It was just like it was just a relentless pursuit of day-to-day activation and marketing that got very well today. And just you require passion to do that. And once we have feedback, we spend weekends at the co-working space, building up the next version of Carousell, and really to figure out how we can improve all the time. And this requires something that you really love doing, and that's why it's important to really figure out if things don't go out well, what will you be happy doing? And that was exactly what we were happy about. Figure out technology, figure out codes, figure out design, and really have solving problems for people. So yeah, these three things are key when you are not happy with status quo, build up these three resilient behavior traits, and you can challenge them. And my grand generation, there were a lot of opportunities. My parents' generation was, they had to work hard to sustain, like, for me. So this is a good music to tell you guys. All the action for you guys. The generation, we can make change. We can easily pick up code. The future is going to be artificial intelligence. A lot of jobs will be automated. So a lot of time now we can now is the opportunity to build up capabilities. And if you look at where the world is development is going to, it will be in Southeast Asia. Indonesia will be a flagship where 150 million people here, if you look at combined ASEAN 600 million people, it's twice the US. And the potential of change for impact or positive impact is all here. And anyone here can actually pick up programming. If you're doing something using technology at scale, you can actually impact so many people around here. So start now. So thank you for listening to my sister's personal sharing. I hope it's useful and happy to like catch up after the session. Thank you so much.
Wow! Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.